I was walking in IKEA the other day and this thing caught my eye. It's a no one cares, just look at those gorgeous sheet metal grills. Then I checked the price. I mean, you already know that I bought it, so let's make something with it. Now, this will only scratch the surface of the possibilities to use these panels, but that's why we have a community, right? I'd love to see other ideas. My idea right now is to make a slightly retro-futuristic enclosure for electronic projects with metal side panels that offer very generous ventilation and potentially pretty good shielding. Just like this mini guitar amp has. I need to cut the two satellite wings from the satellite core. I'm using a Dremel, but this could be done multiple ways. You can even bend it till it breaks, but you still need to kind of file it down somehow. Bend the panels to 90 degree angles. Try to get the corner radius a little tight, but note there's a risk of breaking the paint. So try not to push in more than you need to. Okay, now it's time to open the video description. Could also subscribe on the way there. Go to printables, there's a link in there. And ideally pick the step file so that you can customize the enclosure to fit your project. But you can also download the files that I'm using for this demo. So pause and go print. I'll just wait here in the dark to save you some memory. Prints are ready on my side, so here we have two end caps, a side that could be actually the front interface or could be the bottom of the box, depending on the use case. Two posts to support the corners and connect the two end caps, and a frame that gives further support to the other two corners. Now it's a good time to install the threaded inserts if you choose to use them. In my current design, I'm using four self-tapping screws straight into the plastic. This is for connecting the posts to the end caps, and four threaded inserts to attach the side face. I prefer the self-tapping ones, but the face might need to take a little more unscrewing, and also for demo purposes. Let's finally assemble. Start with an end cap and make that C-shaped metal fit in there. Don't mind mine fitting easily. It's been in there before filming this. You will probably need to adjust a couple of times before it accepts your domination. Posts are next. Mine have two holes for self-tapping screws. Just fit them in there for now. Add the frame on the other side. This one should snap in there. Now add the other cap. This is the trickiest bit. You'll need to have the metal fit well and also put the posts and frame in place, but it's doable. Here I already screwed the posts from the other side, but it didn't help at all, so I didn't want you to make that too. Now screw in both end caps to the posts and we're almost done. Last piece is the front or side or bottom face, however you're looking at it. There will probably be some skew right now in the box, but attaching the face should fix most of it. Brilliant, we're done. Okay, let's talk possibilities as an electronics enclosure. First of all, screens. You could fit all sorts of these small OLEDs, 7-segment displays, LED matrices, etc. You could also have dials, potentiometers, encoders, either on the face or in the top cap if you make it vertical. That knob is a gin bottle cap, by the way. These small speakers also fit in all sorts of directions and configurations. And the generous ventilation would make this great for something like a power amp. Could maybe even ditch the heatsink and bolt it straight to the enclosure, but do correct me if that's a bad idea, please. And I mean, sure, put LEDs in it and make it a lamp, I won't judge. Awesome, let's keep this short and sweet. If you like this video about creating on a budget and making more than the sum of parts, you'll love my video on Griblies. There's a link somewhere here. Catch you in the next one. Catch you in the next one.